In today's Our Region's Business Online Extra, the coronavirus pandemic is having a widespread impact on higher education. Yet the cancellation of ACT and SAT testing this spring has created an opportunity for a Pittsburgh-based company that has emerged as the resource connecting people to K-12 schools and colleges. Investors are even taking notice. Niche.com just closed a $35 million funding round. Luke Skirman is CEO and founder, and he's back with us. Luke, good to see you again.
Great to see you, Bill. Thank you.
Yeah, you're the ultimate sort of digital online company, but I imagine you've had to adjust to the coronavirus like any other business.
Absolutely. You know, this is a big change for all of us. But yeah, our company's working completely remotely now. We're in week 7, and actually, I'm really proud of the team. They're doing an amazing job, and we've kept output extremely high. I would say at the same levels as the pre-pandemic. We're stepping up in this moment for sure.
That's pretty exciting. Yeah, niche has been around for quite a while now. For folks who don't know the company, what's your niche?
So we help students and families research what a school is really like. We've got all 130,000 schools on our profile: kindergartens, middle schools, high schools, colleges, trade schools, grad schools. Over the last year, we've had 100 million visits to the site. And now we're beginning to really work with schools to help them recruit students. We're the number one place now to recruit students online. And so we have great solutions for schools, and we have a great engaging experience for the families and the students as well.
And clearly interest from investors as well. Why'd you go out for the next funding round?
We were really beginning to have success. I mean, we were developing hundreds of client relationships locally. Some of our clients include Carnegie Mellon, Robert Morris, Chatham, Point Park, Shadyside Academy, Central Catholic, St. Edmunds, the Ellis School. Today, we now have 1,400 clients. We believe that there's 40,000 school clients that we can ultimately partner with just in the U.S. alone. So we're having huge success. We're moving really quickly, but we're still at the very early days of how big this can be. It was time to really go after it. We believe that the education industry and the market is massive. There's over $1 trillion a year spent every year in the U.S. education market educating folks, and 70 million students are educated in the economy every year. And how schools really market themselves digitally has been, you haven't seen that same advancement as you've seen in real estate or travel or small business like a Yelp, a TripAdvisor, a Zillow. And we really want to modernize this category and help schools reach these millennial parents, these Gen Z students, and come up with modern solutions for them. And we're driving great results for them. It's really exciting to help them right now.
Yeah, I think about your timing right now. The traditional campus visit is off the table for a while in many places in the United States. Are you seeing more interest in online exploration of colleges right now?
We have more traffic on our college vertical than we do in our than we did this time last year. Families are definitely realizing that they can't access the campus in the way they normally could. This is when typically they would be putting their deposits down and going to visit schools. So they're really needing to use other resources, whether it's a virtual tour or they're looking to a niche to look at all aspects of campus life and really make sure that they're getting a full aspect of what it's really like to be on campus. This is a big decision. It's a multi-year decision. It's an expensive decision. And they want it to be right. And they trust us for our transparency and our thoroughness.
Yeah, you've had the opportunity to survey folks, obviously, in your database that are making these decisions right now. It's been a pretty exhaustive panel you've been able to assemble. What's it telling you about attitudes about college and especially about going to school in the fall?
Yeah, we did conduct one of the biggest survey panels in the country on this topic. We've now successfully surveyed more than 65,000 students and parents. Those are high school students, college students, and parents. And we really wanted to get some information out to the schools so we could help better inform them the sentiment of the market. There's three big takeaways. Takeaway number one was the fall is definitely up for grabs right now. Fall admissions, who's going to enroll, families thinking about the cost of school being closer to home right now, where they were thinking about going, they're rethinking some of those decisions. The second big bucket was the current student body. They're thinking about maybe taking a semester off, maybe transferring out of their current school. And then third big takeaway was that online learning has not been as effective as traditional learning. That was pretty ubiquitous.
So that has real implications. You talk about your colleges as clients. I assume they pay for access to this incredible amount of data you're able to assemble. They've got to be thinking about the fall and that percentage of young people thinking, hey, maybe I'll skip a semester, maybe I'll delay for a year. That has significant financial implications for higher ed as an industry.
Yeah, I mean, higher ed is definitely in a tough spot right now. They're having to innovate and think through how they're going to service this market right now. I think you're seeing them think through their online offerings, their certificate programs, their boot camps. They're trying to figure out ways to not only cater to the traditional market, the high school senior that's thinking about going to college, but there are now 25, 30 million Americans that are unemployed right now that are going to be thinking about how to reskill themselves to get back into the workforce. And when the economy has historically been bad, you usually turn to education to modernize your skills to get back into the market. So I think that the higher education institutions are going to be thinking through not only how to market to the high school students, but to all the adult learners as well out there.
So if people want to find out more about your company or more about schools, and it's not just colleges, it's K through 12 all across the United States, how do they find you? How do they use the site?
Sure. So we have an app and we have a website, so niche.com, N-I-C-H-E.com. We've got every K through 12 school, every college on the site. And then we're progressively going to have more online schools and certificate programs and boot camps coming on the site as well. We're here to help families across the country think through their education choices.
Well, fascinating. Terrific to see the growth of a homegrown company right here in our region. Luke Skirman from niche.com. Thank you so much and continued success.
Thanks, Bill. I really appreciate your continued support and really, really excited to be with you today.
I'm Bill Flanagan, and that's today's Online Extra.